This will be a quick video on WAN 2.2 Stable Video Infinity Pro. And this is a simple workflow for making long videos using the Stable Video Infinity as a LoRa with WAN 2.2 model. Here, I tried generating a 30-second video, and I could have taken this even further if prompted for it. This is the final output with frame interpolation. This node actually contains the full-length video generated, but if we look at the video details, this is a 16 FPS video, which consists of 461 frames. And the above node has more frames, so it gives a 32 FPS video, which consists of 921 frames. Let's look at the workflow and the files required to run this workflow. This section here, we need to select the diffusion models and the LoRa. As I said before, Stable Video Infinity will be used as a LoRa here. These red color nodes are the one where you need to select the files after downloading. So, that was all the red nodes you need to look at. Links to the files are given on the left here. This first link is the link to the video you are watching. And below is the link to the WAN 2.2 high and low noise GGUF models. This node will be loading the high noise model, and this will be loading the low noise model. And below this node, there are two nodes to load the LoRa files. The first node is occupied with a Stable Video Diffusion LoRa. You can see it is selected here. And the second node can be used for some other LoRa if you want to. The model and LoRa then goes to this Set node. Similarly, on the right side, the low noise models with a Stable Video Infinity LoRa goes to the Set node for low noise. This link will take you to the Hugging Face, having all the GGUF files for both high and low noise models. I am using the Q6 GGUF diffusion model, which should also work on a 12 GB card. You can try this Q5 model if you are running an 8 GB card and a 32 GB system RAM. Get files smaller than 8 GB if you are on a 16 GB system. These two are the direct link to the files I am using in this video. Next is the text encoder, and these are the GGUF text encoders. In case you are on a system with smaller memory, it could be a laptop with 16 GB of memory and 8 GB of graphic memory. Get any of the 4 GB text encoders. I have not tested this on a smaller system, so you have to try it to see if it works. This is the direct link to the text encoder file I am using in this video, and it will be selected here. Next is the VAE, which is selected here. So those are the common files we have all the time. Next is the SVI LoRa, which you need to select here and here. The first file is the high noise LoRa. Click and download the file, save it inside the LoRa folder. And then get the low noise LoRa as well. Below is the upscale model, but I have not added the upscale node in this workflow yet. It has been a few hours since I started trying this and removing the unwanted nodes, making changes to keep the workflow simple. The file I selected here was the Lite X2V LoRa, which I always use to generate result in 4 steps instead of 20 steps. However, this time, if you see the name here, this WAN 2.2 model you'll be getting from here is already a distilled Lite X2V 4-step diffusion model. So, the Lightning LoRa, which we usually use as an accelerator, is not selected now. Above there is the block swap node. You can make it 25 if you are on a smaller VRAM system. Remember that it won't work after 40. This torch compile is not in use, and use it if it works for you. The way video generation happens is, at first, I made a 5-second video in this section. This is the normal WAN video workflow with 2K samplers and the text encoder with prompt. You will upload an image here and then adjust the size here. Right now, this 512 pixel video is the best for testing and making the workflow work. You can do a quick test even on a smaller resolution like 480 pixels and check if it is working. Once the result is generated, this preview sample, which is in latent space, and then this source image, which are all the frames generated. Both goes to this section. This is where the video is continued further. This node, named loop starts, is a point. And the loop end is a different point. Between these points, there are connections. And all the nodes connected with these connections will run in a loop, and this loop can happen multiple times. On the left, this loop count is where we put the number of loops to happen. I have kept it as 5, and then the value then sets in this loop count node. The loop count in the get node will be taken here, and then this section will run in loop 5 times. All the nodes in between, including this text node, will run 5 times. Note that I'm not talking about this area. I am talking about all the nodes connected with these wires, between start and end loop node. The reason I want this loop to run 5 times is because the number of prompts given here are 5. In this string node, every new line is treated as a prompt. So if I want the video to be generated on each prompt, then I need all the video generating nodes to keep running in a loop 5 times, which will be for each line in the string node above. When running the first loop, the first prompt gets in process, and the output is then shown here, and here as well. The difference is this node will show the latest one video from the loop, and this node will be combining all the output together. Right now, there are 5 results of 81 frames generated in the loop, and all are combined here. I hope you got this section. The loop runs 1 by 1 5 times for each prompt, and then the 5th result is visible here, and this is the combined video from all the loop. This loop end node takes all the frames, even the first 5-second video frames, all are combined, which makes the 30-second video in this video combine node. For reference, here I have written combined video, which is the first 5-second plus multiple videos from the loop. The same output then goes to the interpolation node, and then we get a 32 FPS result. The time taken to generate this video was 13 minutes. I did not pay attention properly, but I think the frame interpolation took 4 minutes. The time it should have taken is around 8 minutes on my 4060 Ti 16GB card. So, I'm taking a random image from Civit AI. It looks good to me. Upload the image. I have cropped the image from the top. I just don't want the subject to be small in the image because the resolution I am generating video is already small. I will quickly modify the prompt. This should work. I suggest taking a smiling photo of the subject to make this type of video. Bypass this section and first generate the 5-second video. I cancel the process because I forgot to change the aspect ratio. I have reversed the resolution. Now it should be working. One step takes around 11 seconds. And it took 85 seconds to get this result. I will go through these prompts quickly. So I have made a few changes to make it work with this image. Make sure to check the loop count before proceeding from here. Activate the nodes and run the workflow. The video generation process began from the loop because on the right I have the seed ID fixed, which gives the same video as an output. It takes 12 seconds for one step. I got the result from first loop. And after some time, I got the full result. The frame interpolation is still in process, and it takes time, which adds up in the total generation time. Again, the total time taken was 13 minutes, out of which 540 minutes was taken by the frame interpolation node. So that is it in this video. Workflow will be in the given link. I hope this was helpful, and have an excellent day.